gates of Babylon, where he sat down, and there he went, when he remembered Zion. Oh, but the wicked carry us away, captivity required from us a song. You're listening to One Gospel. This is the sixth supplement for version 2, part 3, Jesus' genealogies, taken from Matthew 1:1-17 and Luke 3:23-38. So we see here, and Solomon fathered Boaz by Rahab. And when you look at the footnotes, you see that this is Rahab. So there is a Rahab in the Old Testament. Let's learn a little bit more about her. This is from the book of Joshua. As you may recall, Joshua's the English translation of Yehoshua, which is the early Hebrew version of Yeshua's name, meaning Yahweh is salvation. And we're going to look at the literal translation of the Hebrew text from Joshua 2:1-13. Go ahead, Holly.
And Joshua, son of Nun, sendeth from Shittim two men, spies, silently saying, go see the land and Jericho. And they go and come into the house of a woman, a harlot, and her name is Rahab, and they lie down there. And the king of Jericho sendeth unto Rahab, saying, bring out the men who are coming unto thee. And the woman taketh the two men and hideth them. And she saith unto the men, I have known that Jehovah hath given to you the land, and that your terror hath fallen upon us, and that all the inhabitants of the land have melted at your presence. For we have heard how Jehovah dried up the waters of the Red Sea at your presence in your going out of Egypt, and that which ye have done to the two kings of the Amorite, who are beyond the Jordan, and to Sihon and Og, whom ye devoted. And we hear, and melteth our heart, and there hath not stood any more spirit in any man from your presence, for Jehovah your God, he is God in the heavens above and on the earth beneath. And now swear ye, I pray you, to me by Jehovah, because I have done with you kindness that ye have done, even ye kindness with the house of my father, and have given to me a true token, and have kept alive my father and my mother and my brothers and my sisters and all that they have, and have delivered our souls from death.
So we have here, again, this is a condensed version where you see ellipses. I took out some of the text just to make this rendition easier to get to the point. I did not change the words otherwise, though. We have Rahab, who's a prostitute in Jericho, which is where the spies went to hang out when they were going to spy out the land. And this prostitute made this statement of faith that Yahweh is God in the heavens above and on the earth beneath. And she asked them to basically make an oath by Yahweh that because she has dealt kindly with them, that they will spare both her and her family. So Rahab was in fact spared. And so after the destruction of Jericho, she wouldn't have worked as a harlot anymore. And so the assumption is that she would have integrated into Israelite society. And so it is very possible that Rahab could have married one of the sons of Israel and had children. It is very possible that it is this Rahab that is part of the line of Yeshua, the Messiah. There's a few things to remember. Number one, again, when they're looking at the context, what are the people who are the followers of Yeshua and the followers of Matthew? What would they have been thinking? And when they heard Rahab, well, they would have thought of her as a prostitute. And that combined with Tamar, who played the role of a prostitute with the father of her child, Judah. This is again this is part of the line of Yeshua. But another thing to remember is that this is not recorded in the Hebrew scriptures that Rahab was in the line of David, for example. This is something that Matthew tells us that we don't know of otherwise. So whether he had information in the genealogies, which we don't have available to us, or whether this was inspired outside of an actual written record, is ultimately unknown. Holly, what picture do we have before us today?
We have The Harlot of Jericho and the Two Spies by James Jacques Joseph Tissot, 1896 to 1902. And it's a gauche on board.
Thanks, Holly. And thank you for your attention.